Functions of money. Functions of money can be broadly classified into two categories, primary functions and secondary functions. Primary functions. First, medium of exchange. This is the most important function of money. Money is an instrument which acts as a medium of exchange for goods and services. Exchange of goods and services implies sale and purchase of goods and services. In absence of money, under barter system, goods were exchanged for goods which require double coincidence of wants, due to which the exchange was difficult and therefore limited. The double coincidence of wants means a transaction can happen only when I want to purchase what you are selling and you want to purchase what I want to sell. Money, being a standard medium of exchange, overcomes this problem. What is the importance of this function? Exchange becomes easier as it doesn't require double coincidence of wants, that is, simultaneous sale and purchase. Size of the market of every product and service has been increased due to this function of money. Common unit of value or standard unit of account. Money is something which is acceptable to all. So money serves as a standard unit of account in which all the goods and services can be measured. It provides common measure of value of goods and services being exchanged. Knowing the value or price of a good in terms of money enables both seller and purchaser of the good to make decisions about how much quantity of the goods to supply and how much quantity of the goods to purchase. In barter system, there was no common unit in which all the commodities can be measured. It becomes very difficult to determine the value of commodity in terms of another commodity. After evolution of money, it serves as a standard unit of account, which is easy to value goods and services as well as acceptable by all. For example, wheat can be valued at rupees 1500 per quintal. This function of money facilitated comparison between the markets. Accounting of transactions is now possible due to this function of money. Growth can numerically measured in terms of GDP due to this function of money. Secondary functions. Standard for deferred payment. Deferred payments are those payments which are to be made in future. These payments are also known as contractual payments. Loans and borrowings requiring future repayments are quite difficult in barter system, as there is no standard basis for future payments in the barter system. Borrowings in terms of commodities can be paid back with higher units of that commodity for compensating the interest. But quality of paying goods may not be the same as borrowed goods, and its value may also change. Money can be easily used as standard for future payment as its value remains stable. Importance of this function. This led to emergence of lending and borrowing, that is, emergence of financial markets. Money in the form of demand deposit has been emerged. Availability of credit has increased the consumption as well as investment expenditure in the economy. So rate of growth has also increased. Store of value. Money is durable, portable, liquid and divisible. So store of value in terms of money is very convenient. Store of value implies store of wealth. Barter system doesn't allow any convenient system of storage of value, as storing wealth in terms of food grains and cattle is quite expensive. Even food grains are perishable in nature. Storing wealth in terms of money is very easy, as money can be stored easily in terms of paper titles and even in bank. Importance of this function. Easy storage of wealth in money form has increased the savings. Stored savings lead to investment, which is a key reason of growth and development. Transfer of value. Money is highly liquid and portable. Money acts as a convenient mode of transfer of value. Transfer of value in barter system is very difficult as food grains and cattle are quite bulky. Money can be easily transferred from one place to another, either in pocket or through banks. Importance of this function. This function has facilitated investment across the borders. Mobility of capital has increased due to this function of money.